Welcome back. So, today we are going to be looking at Battle Pass vehicles. This may not be the quickest video out there because, unlike the Battle Pass soldiers, and more like the Battle Pass weapons, we're probably going to have to jump around and look at all the different nations. Mind you, I can't see every single one on these lists because I do have some of them and will probably have to flip through my tech tree a little bit to, or my, I guess, catalog of squads to find some of them. But let's talk about these. There's been a few people who brought to my attention that the Battle Pass is coming to a close, and because of that, a lot of you are getting your gold vehicle orders, and you wonder what to do with them. So, I guess the first place to start is figuring out which nation is your favorite. And that's only the pick a vehicle. You could also be branching out to a new nation, but you need to figure out what your motivation is, where you want to spend it, before we can, you know, really get into the meat and potatoes of which specific vehicle. So, for example, back in the day, I had played a lot of America, I'd played a lot of Germany, but I hadn't played a lot of Russia, and I knew I was far enough off from getting the high-end tank slots for Germany that I wanted to wait and spend one there later. But I was starting to get into playing Russia, and people had suggested that if you're going to play Russia, especially if you were going to play the Moscow campaign back in the day, one of the best things to do would be to grab the T-50. So I figured, well, I'm starting this new nation, I haven't played them a whole lot, people say this is good, so that's what I did. But you might be different. You might be a one nation Joe, and you might just play that one nation and it's your favorite. But you might also be branching out, or you might just want a vehicle because it's powerful. But I think the first step is figuring out what your motivation is. So, starting from there, let's look at what's recently been the most popular nation in the game, Germany. And what is good in Germany? Now, not pictured here, there should be a BF-110 that I have, a Panzer IV F2, and a Tiger I. I think that's everything that I have Battle Pass-wise for Germany. As far as what I would suggest for Germany, the first thing I would seriously look at is the Tiger I, which I want to say, let me scroll through, it should be on my list somewhere. I know it's in one of my other squads, but anyway, it's a Tiger I. Assuming that that one's available, I would go for it. It's pretty much identical to this Tiger I-E. What I wanted to see is which squad in particular it can go on, because obviously it does not go on this Tiger II squad. So, let's take a look. It might go on that one. Yeah, okay, so here it is. So, it is a fully upgraded Tiger E. Now, every Battle Pass vehicle you get, similar to every Battle Pass soldier you get, and every Battle Pass gun, they're all going to come fully upgraded. And I think that's the main draw, the main reason why you would want a Battle Pass vehicle. Because right now, upgrading these vehicles, like if we wanted to upgrade this Tiger, even with the 40,000 or 40% discount, it's still 4,500 for the first upgrade. I can tell you upgrading the final upgrade on a Tiger 2 was like 50,000 silver, or something close to that. So it gets extremely expensive to upgrade these vehicles. So being able to get a fully upgraded vehicle is fantastic. Now, what I was hoping to see is if it listed which squads this can go on. Normally when you go into the shop it will, but the reason why I bring this up is in order to use a Battle Pass vehicle, you need the corresponding squad researched, because it doesn't come with a squad, it only comes with the vehicle. So, if you use the crew off the Panther A, for example, and you don't have the Panther A unlocked, then it won't be a useful vehicle for you. So if we go in and look at some of these, if we look at this, see, it'll show you it can go on these two squads. Or for this one, it can go on this squad. So you can figure out from there which squad it is in the tech tree. Just make sure, if you're going to buy a squad, if there's something that interests you, make sure you go and you look and see which squads are available for it before you, you know, bite and get it. Because if you're a brand new player who's just starting out Germany, and you look at this and you're like, oh boy, a Tiger 1, I want a Tiger 1, and you get it, it could be a very, very long time before you get to use the Tiger 1. And there are other low-tier vehicles that can be very effective. So, another example of a vehicle that I have. Let's see. That's for G-E-N. That's not the right one. This one. This should be it. Yeah, okay, so this is from Tunisia. I'm not sure if this one's still available. If it is, it's not the most competitive Panzer IV out there. But I thought it was cool because it had the flag on the roof. That's the main reason that I went for this one. So that gets into the other point of why you get a Battle Pass vehicle. Battle Pass vehicles all have unique skins on them, or unique camos on them. And the other thing that gives them value is that appearance. So, basically, they have value because you don't have to upgrade them, and they have value because some of them look cool. So going back to the shop, there used to be a BF-110 that had a mouth on it. I don't think it's available right now, though, but it looked cool, so that was a reason to get that one. As far as the rest of these in here, if I was looking at picking something up, if you like planes and you're at low tier, I would look at the JU-87B2 and the BF-110. The BF-110s with the 250 kilo bombs can actually be extremely effective. In Moscow, I picked up one of these. Not this one, obviously, because I could still get this one, but it effectively is the same as this plane, and it served me very well. Having two 250 kilo bombs can be absolutely devastating. You can pretty much take out any armor that you're going to encounter, whether it's at BR3, BR1, BR5, because as BR3 you're going to be able to see 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, depending on how the matchmaker treats you that day. So if you don't really have a lot of planes unlocked, and you want one that's fully upgraded, that can kind of do it all, this is going to be a really good plane. The BF-110s, they actually fight other planes deceptively well. Their max turn time is right around 19 seconds, but for a plane that's as big, as fat, and carries as much ordnance as this does, that's actually really good. And it still has a pretty respectable armament on it, with its 220 mils and all of its 7.7s, or 7.92s rather. So I do like that one. The JU-87B2 also is a decent choice. This one maybe more so because it's BR2 and you can still get protected matchmaking. Now, this one isn't going to do very well fighting other planes because it only has machine guns, it doesn't have any cannons. But it can turn pretty well at 16.5 seconds, and the main draw to it is that you can multi-drop with it. You should be able to get three drops out of it with four sets of 50 kilo bombs dropping in sets of two, and a single 250 kilo bomb. So again, even if you play up later on and you don't have another plane that you would like to take, this can still pretty much take out any vehicle in the game because of its 250 kilo bomb, as long as you're accurate with it. And the JU-87s being a purpose-built dive bomber, you're going to be able to be very accurate with them. And, you know, if you like the whole Stuka vibe, all of the Stukas in this game have Jericho sirens. They all scream when they come down from above, and that can be its own little intimidating reward for you. As far as stepping up higher, the G14, one of my friends actually just picked it up. He was looking for a plane to shoot down other planes with at high BR, and he likes it quite a bit. I've been jumping between the K4, the G10, and the G14 in high tier battles, and I haven't really decided which one my favorite is yet, but the G14 does actually perform exceptionally well. Having a 16 second turn time, and having 320 mils, and having 213 mils on top of that, is actually a very potent set of firepower. Now, you don't have a ton of ammo for your guns, so you do have to pick and choose your shots, but you have enough that you should be able to deal with a wing of bombers if you shoot well, and as long as you're cycling for ammo frequently, you should be able to keep the skies pretty clean. So I like that one. I think I would probably skip over the biplane. It's got an okay bomb load, but it's BR1, and I think you're better off going with the JU-87. As far as the tanks go, the Panther G is always going to be a good option if you like Panthers. If you see the Tiger 2, or the Tiger 1 rather, that I have, I would pick that up assuming that you're capable of using it. I think it's probably the best vehicle you can get out of the battle pass right now for Germany. Mind you, the Tiger 1 is by far not an invincible tank. There are many vehicles in the game that can defeat it, but you have a very powerful gun, and if you angle it and you position yourself well, you can do wonders with it. If, for example, you're not a huge fan of the way the Panther G looks, the Panther A is also a good option. Uses the 3rd Panzer Regiment. My experience with Panther A's has been pretty good, just understand that the Panther A is relatively thin. I do like the way this particular skin looks, though. But there are a lot of things in this game that can kill Panther A's pretty easily. I think, though, if I had to choose between the two, even though I think the Panther A probably looks better, I think the Panther G is probably the more effective tank. So between the two, since they both use the 3rd Panzer Regiment, I would probably look at the Panther G. But it can also go on the 503rd if you unlock the heavier tank regiment later on. If you like Stugs, the Stug is an option. I personally would stay away from the Stug, though. The thing is, this is the only free way to get a Stug, is if, you know, you come across a gold vehicle order and you can spend it. Because it was, I believe, in the paid section of Stalingrad, and there is a premium one. But the problem that I run into with Stugs is, number one, they're BR3, and I think that all hull-locked vehicles should be a BR lower than their turreted counterparts. Additionally, it doesn't have a machine gun, and not having a machine gun doesn't sound like a big deal on a tank, but I promise it is. The gun, I'm sure, fires relatively quickly, but you're going to run into instances where it would be more efficient for you to fire the machine gun because somebody's like running up to you and you don't want to waste a tank shell on one guy, or because you're stuck in a reload waiting for the gun to come back up. So, if you were going to look at the Stug, unless you're a diehard fan of Stugs, I would instead tell you should look at the Panzer IV F2 because it is also BR3, I think it looks better, and because you have a turret, I think you're going to be more effective. Alternatively, if you're looking for a low-tier vehicle, the Panzer IIIN is actually very good. I have the Stalingrad version of this, and I have the premium version of this. Now, there's a couple of differences there. The premium version is basically going to be exactly this, and it performs very well. It gets APCBC, and it gets HE. And the HE shells do pretty well, but the thing is, it's got the short 75 on it, so it reloads very quickly, and you can pump out shots with it. It also carries a very respectable amount of ammo, I think 64 rounds, and you also have a roof machine gun, so you can pop out and shoot them with that, but you also have a coax machine gun, so you don't have to expose your commander to use your machine gun. But it's a vehicle you'll get access to pretty early on, and at BR2, it's going to be a very respectable tank. Alternatively, you can look at the Panzer IV-E, which it's going to perform similarly. You're going to get more ammo with it, but I think if it were me, I would probably go for the Panzer III, just because you're going to have better armor on the Panzer III with your side skirts, and you're usually more mobile in Panzer IIIs. Yeah, by about 11 kilometers an hour, you're going to be more mobile. You can also look at the Panzer IIIJ at BR1, but I think that I would rather wait and go for the Panzer IIIN at BR2. Even if you have to unlock a few more things, I think you're going to get a lot more value out of the Panzer IIIN. Now, the Panzer IIIJ will probably do better at blowing up tanks, but it does only have the short 50mm. If it had the long 50mm, I think I could recommend it more. But that is about it for Germany. We're going to look at Japan next, and I don't have any of the Japanese ones. You don't have as many choices, though, so here I would definitely look at the Zero. As far as an air-to-air fighter, it's your only choice here, but the Zero is also a very effective fighter. It only has an 11.5-second turn time, which is phenomenal. That's extremely low. To give you context, most planes in the game turn somewhere between 16 and 20 seconds, with the bigger, heavier planes like the BF-110s being closer to 19, and some of the more agile fighters like the BF-109s are going to be closer to like 16, 17, and some of your Russian planes, like your really agile Russian planes like your Yaks and whatnot, they're going to be sitting there right around like 16 flat. So getting a plane that can turn in 11.5 seconds is absolutely insane. It also carries 250 kilo bombs, which are pretty small, but you can probably take out some infantry with it. So I think it is probably your best pickup in Japan. You just understand that you need the correct crew to use it. It is a BR2 plane though, so you should be able to get that crew relatively quickly if that's something you're interested in. Now, the rest of the Japanese vehicles are the Kami and the Hago. And so basically there's three Hagos. And you do get access to the Hago pretty early, but if you're considering spending a gold order on a Hago, I would really caution you against it. I just don't like the gun on the Hago. I think that they're neat little tanks, but I think you'd be way better off saving your order and hoping that something better comes out in the future, or spending it on a different nation. If you're dead set on spending it on Japan, though, the Kami is probably the route that I would go, just because it's amphibious. But I think the Japanese Battle Pass tanks are pretty lacking. So, moving on from Japan, I know they were very quick. Let's look at America. So, for America, trying to think. I'm pretty sure I do have some of the American vehicles. I'm just not sure which ones I have. And I'm not sure if I'd be able to see in here which ones I have without going through everything. I want to say I picked up one of the Shermans at some point. Anyway, it's really not that important. If we go into this, which vehicles are going to be good for America? So, this P-51 here, it's a BR-3 plane. This, I think, is one of the best pickups you can get in the American tech tree. The reason for that is that this P-51 comes with two 500-pound bombs. And that makes it exceptionally good. It has 17.7 second turn time, it's got 650 cals, it's a very respectable attack plane, or dogfighter, I guess is more what I'm getting at. Both. It's a very effective attack plane because it's getting two 500-pound bombs, so to compare them back to the Germans, this is carrying the same bomb loadout that you carried on the Bf 110, but it's also going to be a very good plane for fighting other planes. At BR-3, 350 cals is more than enough. You are gonna have to sit on your target a little bit longer, but you carry a lot of ammo and you basically can just hold the trigger down. And the thing is, American planes, especially if you're not a good pilot, are very forgiving because you can sit there and hold down the trigger and walk your rounds on target. Even if you don't have it perfect to begin with, you can just hold down the trigger and you can keep shooting until you get your rounds on target and the target's dead. It's not ideal, mind you, but they're more forgiving than other nations because of their high ammo count. But this is one of the planes in the game that will do very well in all roles, and because of that, I highly recommend it. Plus, being at BR-3, having a good plane that can play up and can play down, especially when you're playing up into the Tiger II threats, is going to do you wonders. And this plane can absolutely deal with your Tiger IIs. You just need to learn to be precise with your bombs. Also, the Germans at high tier are going to start bringing out their Ju-188s, and they're going to bring out at BR-3 their Bf 110s with their 30 mm cannon and their Panzerwerfers, or their Werfer grenades, I guess is more accurate. But the point is, there are a lot of threats that Germany can throw at you, whether they're in the air or they're on the ground, and this plane can deal with all of them, and that's why I recommend it. If you want an alternative to that plane, though, the A-20 is actually a very competitive alternative, and I think it has one of the best skins in the game. I love the whole invasion stripe system on it, and I also like the bomb decal. Now, you're gonna get more strike potential with this plane because you're gonna have twice as many bombs as the P-51, but just be aware. You're also going to turn like a bit of a whale because the turn time on this one is just over 20 seconds. Now, you do get some tail gunners. They might be able to help you out a little bit. And I guess the other draw to this is the closest thing to a B-25 that we have in game right now. So, if what you want is to roll up and play a frontline bomber, well, this is it, buddy. In my experience, the tech tree one is pretty good. I imagine the fully upgraded one is also probably pretty good, but I think a plane like this doesn't gain as much value by being fully upgraded because you're never going to turn well. Even on the fully upgraded one, like, you'll be a little bit faster, you'll turn a little bit better, but it's probably not going to be enough to save your life. So, if I had to pick between the two, I'd probably go for Hurry Home, Honey, the P-51 D5NA. But that's just me. As far as other options, the AP-1 isn't a bad option either. It carries the same bomb load as the P-51, though. It gets the benefit of being a carrier plane for the Pacific, but I don't think I would go for it. Just me personally. I think the P-51, because it carries the same bomb loadout and because it can double as a fighter, I just don't think that this competes as well. You do have a lot of options as far as squadrons you can put it on, though, so that may make it easier to put this on a crew. I'm just not 100% sure. That's something you would have to look at if you're going to pick it up. Again, it's not a bad plane. It turns alright at 17 seconds. It carries a good bomb loadout. It's just, if you fly the P-51, you can do everything it does, and you can be a fighter. As far as low tier, your only plane option is going to be the FP-3, which is essentially a Wildcat. You're getting two 100-pound bombs, which are very small, and you're getting 450 cals and a 16-second turn time. So as a dedicated fighter for low BR, it's probably going to perform very well. If you only play low BR, you might consider looking at it, but I think you might be better served picking up a tank if you're going to play only low BR. Because as America, you have the option at BR2 to pick up the Grant. And the Grant is a very, very powerful tank. Now, it does take some getting used to. You have two guns on it. You have this Casemate 75, which is very powerful, and you have a smaller 37 on the roof in a turret. The tank has phenomenal armor, and it can stand up to most things that you'll see. There are exceptions. You have to protect your casemate because some things can shoot through the casemate. But in general, it has some of the best armor available at BR2. Just understand that it takes a little bit of getting used to. And if you have to level the squad that this goes into, it can be very frustrating until you get the full crew. Because this is a very large tank with a 6-man crew, and you really need that whole crew. Because you have two guns you need to load, two guns you need to aim. The tank feels a lot better if you don't have to worry about your commander leaving the commander seat every time you switch to one of the gun views. But once you get the full crew in here, it can become a very rewarding tank, and you can do incredible things with it. So this is my recommendation for a low-tier vehicle for America. I think it's going to be a way better investment than the plane. And I think it's probably going to be a better investment than any of the other low-tier tanks, but we'll still look at them. Now, moving on, I think your second best bet at low BR is going to be the Crusader. And I really don't think the Crusader is a bad option. It's going to be, I believe it's more mobile than the Grant. Yeah, okay, it is more mobile. It's just not by as much as I thought. It's only about 4 kilometers an hour faster. But the benefit to the Crusader is that it only requires a 3-man crew. So, if you haven't leveled your tank crew at all, this one you'll be able to just pick up and go with. And it is still going to be fairly effective. It hits a 57mm cannon, which is pretty good for BR2. Some tanks will have bigger cannons, like the Grant has a 75. The Panzer IIIs have short 75s. But most of the vehicles you're going to run into have 50 mils, 45 mils, and smaller. So this is going to be a very effective cannon for its BR, and you also get a machine gun. And the nice thing about most of the British machine guns on tanks is that they don't overheat very quickly. They don't have the greatest fire rate in the world, but you can also just sit there and keep shooting, which, when you're getting swarmed by infantry and you need to shoot lots of them, I would much rather have a machine gun that doesn't overheat than a machine gun like an MG42, for example, that fires very quickly and overheats constantly. So this can be a very good option. This is actually probably the better option if you're truly new to the game, and the Grant is probably the best overall option. But it comes with all the caveats that I mentioned before about it being frustrating and you have to level the crew and so on and so on and so on. Where the Crusader, you don't have to worry about all that. Lastly, at low BR, we have the M8 Stars. Now, the M8 Stars can be very, very powerful because it's an M8 Scott and it's got this short 75 howitzer. It can do a lot of damage against infantry, but it's going to require a more careful, more pragmatic and more advanced playstyle, you're going to have to be very careful to keep your crew alive and to keep the enemy as far away from you as you can, because you are open-topped and anything that they throw on top of your tank has the potential to kill you. Personally, I wouldn't go for it, but I don't really care for open-top vehicles. I guess you also have the option of the M13. If you really like AA guns, the M13's an option. It does look kind of cool, but I think I would stay away from it. I think you get a lot more value out of the other options. Now, as far as higher tier choices, at BR3 you do have the choice of the Sherman 2. I think this particular Sherman 2 has one of the best looking skins, so if you're purely going for fashion, I think that this is probably your best choice. I think your choice really is between the Sherman 2 and the A20. Maybe you could argue the M1 A176 in the mood, but I think this is probably the most unique looking vehicle here. So, if you're dead set on getting a tank at BR3, it's not going to be a bad choice. Shermans are very effective, but it would not be my first choice. Only because the P51 is at the same BR, and I think you'll probably get more mileage out of the P51. Because the thing with planes is that they play up very well. Tanks don't play up as well. When a plane plays up, most of the guns on most of the planes, as long as you at least have a 50 cal machine gun, and as long as you have some sort of ordnance, you can impact the battle. With a tank, you're restricted by the armor of your tank and the gun of your tank, and the difference between a BR3 and a BR5 tank is pretty severe. So, you'll always be able to deal with infantry at every BR with a tank. You just will be a tin can once you play up, and assuming that the other team is pulling out their AT weapons and they're using their own tanks, it can be a very hostile environment. Now, if you're top tier and you're playing down to tier 1, 2, and 3, the Sherman 2 is going to do you wonders. I just have a hard time recommending you a vehicle that's only going to be useful half the time. Looking at your other higher tier options, personally, I would stay away from the M10 because it is an open-topped vehicle, and because the tank we're going to look at after this effectively does the same thing better. But if you're dead set on getting a tank destroyer, this is your option. You do get a roof-mounted 50 cal, you do get an effective main gun, but you're at BR4, and most of the tanks that you're going to see at BR4, well, they're going to be able to kill you, and some of them you're not going to be able to kill. You'll do fine against Panthers, you'll probably do fine against Tiger 1s, but come the Tiger 2s, you're probably going to struggle. And you're going to have to deal with all the Panzerfausts and Molotovs and Flamethrowers and AT mines and everything else that you already have to deal with at BR 4 and 5 with infantry, so I would personally stay away from it. The M4 A176W in the mood, I think, does the same thing that it does, but you have a roof. So if you're gonna pick a tank, I think this is the one. I still think I would go with the P51, because I think it's the best flex pick that you can get. But the M4 A176W in the mood does look pretty cool, and if you want a tank on the ground, I think it'll serve you admirably. So, rounding things out with America, my first choice would be the P51D. If you understand what you have to put into it, I think the Grant would be my second choice, but tied for the Grant would be the Crusader. Finally, moving on to the USSR. In the USSR, I think the two best choices... you actually have some very competitive options, but the two best choices that you're going to have on the ground are probably going to be the KV-1 Hit the Fascists and the IS-1, and we'll go into more detail about them. But let's start with the KV-1. Now, number one, I think the KV-1 looks really cool. I like the Cyrillic up here on the sides of the tank. and I think the camo scheme looks pretty good. But why the KV-1? Well, the KV-1 is just a very thick tank. So it will start to run into some issues playing at BR4, but unless you run into Panthers, it can actually deal very well with most of the tanks at BR4. Like all the Panzer IVs with the long guns, you used to see them in Stalingrad. And as long as you angled the tank and you were careful, you could actually deal with them very well. Playing at BR3 and BR2 and BR1, this thing is going to be absolutely devastating. The thing with the KV-1 is, uniquely amongst tanks in this game, even if you throw TNT packs on it, it doesn't always die. Like, lots of tanks in this game, if you run up to it and you throw a TNT pack at it, or you place one on it, a lot of them, they just die. The KV-1, I can't tell you why, but in my experience, it has a knack for surviving things that would destroy other tanks. Beyond that, the gun is respectable for dealing with infantry. It's not the best for dealing with tanks, but as long as you're only seeing Panzer IVs, you can do pretty well. If you get the sides of Panthers, you'll absolutely take them apart. Seeing BR5 is going to be difficult for it, but the thing is, in my experience playing BR5, both as and against Germany, half the time you see Tiger 2Hs, and they'll absolutely demolish you. The other half of the time, they're pulling up Panzer IV Js, and on rare occasion, like earlier today, they sometimes pull out Panzer IIs. And if you see any of that, you're going to do just fine. And then, like I said, if you play down into BR2, you're going to be the king of the hill. They'll have to bomb you. They'll probably have to bomb you repeatedly. You're going to have a good time. I highly recommend the KV-1 hit the fascists. Looking at the IS-1, I actually think the IS-1 is the best tank in the Russian tech tree. And I know that sounds weird. Why is the IS-1 the best tank in the tech tree when the IS-2 exists? And there's even two variants of the IS-2. The difference between the IS-1 and the IS-2, like the normal standard non-1944 variant of the IS-2, is just the gun. The hull armor is identical. The turret probably is shaped a little bit differently to accommodate the larger gun on the IS-2, but effectively what you have in the IS-1 is an 85mm cannon that's going to reload significantly faster than the IS-2, and as long as you aim your shots properly, you'll be able to punch through everything that the Germans throw at you. I absolutely have gotten killed in my Tiger 2H by people that are using the IS-1 and by people that are using T-34-85s. I can't tell you exactly where I am because it's not something that I've personally practiced a lot, but I know that it's possible because I've gotten killed by it. But you're also getting all of the armor that you would get on the standard IS-2. Now, the IS-244 does have a better armor layout because the sloping is better, but I've been trying to use the IS-2 1944 a lot lately, and the reload is so long that it's punishing. Most of the time when you run up against German tanks, like if you run into a Panther can punch through an IS-2 1944's armor reliably, and he can fire like 3 times in the time it takes you to fire 1 shot. So if he gets the drop on you while you're reloading, he's probably going to kill you unless you can get a severe angle or get out of sight. And if you whiff your first shot against a Panther, you're done. But with an IS-1, I think it's a more even playing field because your gun reloads so much faster. It makes it more competitive in those armor duels. Mind you, the 122 will go through pretty much anything you put in front of it, and it's going to have a much larger HE radius to blow up other infantry and whatnot. But the 85 is very respectable. I mean, remember, the Germans are shooting with an 88. This is only a 3mm smaller shell than what the Germans have. So I think this is probably the way to go if you want a high-tier tank. It is really your only choice. I guess you can go with the SU-85, which, to be fair, the SU-85 is a very respectable choice. And it's also going to stand up really well from the front. I wish I could use the armor viewer here, but the mantlet on these is relatively strong. And it still has the same 85mm cannon. The downside is you're not getting a machine gun in your hull locked, so if you don't mind that, this is a decent option, and I believe you'll be able to use it earlier, because you get the crew first with that. But personally, I would go for the IS-1 if you can. As far as planes go, the IL-2 1941 is going to be a phenomenal plane at low BR. It is a BR-2 plane, and until you get the IL-2M at BR-3, I think this is the gold standard for CAS for Russia. You're getting eight rockets that fire in pairs of two, so four rocket drops, and you're also getting 450-kilo bombs that drop in pairs of two for two bomb drops. So you can take apart enemy advances with this plane. I've flown it extensively, not this one in particular, I've flown the tech tree variant, but I've flown it extensively at BR-2. It is fantastic. I've played it up into BR-5 games, and it is still fantastic. I think that the IL-2M is a little bit better, but it's also a higher BR plane, and you do get less drops with it. I highly recommend the IL-2 1941, though, as far as attack planes go. And as far as attack planes go, it is your only option here, but it performs very well. Now, looking at the other planes, I actually need to look at their stats a little bit. I don't really have a lot of experience with Russian fighters. I usually just throw a Russian attack plane on, or I throw the P-40 on, but there is not a Battle Pass P-40. So, going from my own experience, the LA-5 is going to be a pretty good fighter. It turns at 16.5 seconds, and it carries 250-kilo bombs, and it gets two 20mm Shabaks, and that's really the draw to it. It turns pretty well, and it gets two very good 20mm cannons. The bombs are a bit lacking, though. So, it's going to be a decent option at BR-3. Although, again, personally, unless you're dead set on getting a fighter, I think I would personally go for the IL-2, just because I think you can do a lot more, even if you play it up. Admittedly, the camo on the plane, or the skin on the plane, does look very nice. I like the red nose, I like the order of the red banner, and I do like the stripe with the red star here in the number. I think it's a really good-looking plane. The IL-2 might be a little bit better looking because camo, but that's personal preference, I guess. The AK-1, as far as like a low-tier plane goes, as a fighter, I think it's going to perform very well. Now, the nice thing here is that you're getting two 100-kilo bombs, but you're getting two Shikas machine guns and one 20mm cannon. At BR-2, you should be able to deal with most things you see, but one of the issues that Russian planes run into is that they have very low ammo counts normally, and this is no exception. You only have 110 rounds for your Shabak cannon, so you're going to have to pick your shots and be very careful. I think I would still go with the IL-2 over the Yak. The Yak is going to be a better dogfighter, obviously, but you're going to be able to do much more for your team in an IL-2, and in my experience, the IL-2 is agile enough that it can double as an air defense plane if you need to. It's not the fastest plane in the world, but it can take a lot of punishment, and it can turn in a little over 15 seconds, so I think it performs very well. Your other option for a low-tier fighter is going to be the MiG, which I think the MiG has a phenomenal appearance. I love the white plane with the red lettering and the red arrow and the red stars. I think it looks awesome. But having a plane that turns in 18.6 seconds and is supposed to be a fighter, I think is not very good. It's very fast at 630 kilometers an hour, and it has two 20mm Shavaks, so you're going to be able to do quite a bit of damage with it, But you still don't have very much ammo. You have about 100 rounds per gun. So you're going to, again, have to pick your shots. If you don't mind its inability to turn, it might be an alright plane. Again, I think the IL-2 is just the best option that you have here. Then looking at the AK-7B, this is going to be a BR-2 plane. It turns in 15.98 seconds, it flies at almost 600 kilometers an hour, it gets one Chevac, it gets two 50 cal Bursen machine guns, and it gets two 50 kilo bombs. This is probably the best competition that the IL-2 has, because it's also a BR-2 plane. It also turns pretty well. It is faster. But as good as it's probably going to be as a fighter, I still think you're going to do much more for your team in the IL-2. So, if I was going to pick a fighter, for low BR, it would be the AK-7B. For anything above BR-3, it would be the LA-5. The LA-5 will do fine, it's just you're only going to be a fighter with it. The 50 kilo bombs are going to be usable, but you're going to have to basically drop them on people's heads. I think the IL-2 is probably the single most valuable plane that you can get, because even though you're slow, it can take a lot of punishment, it turns very well, you get 20mm cannons, so you can take apart enemy bombers with it, you can take apart enemy planes with it. You're not going to outrun anybody, and you're probably not going to chase them down, but you can do all of those things in addition to putting an unspeakable amount of punishment down on enemy troops and tanks and whatnot that are on the ground. Then, as far as low BR tanks, your choices between the T-70 and the BT-7, I would go with the BT-7. The T-70 is going to have a 45mm 20K cannon, and it can go at about 45 kilometers an hour. It really doesn't have a ton of armor, but it does have 50 mils on the front of the turret. It might just be my experience seeing people play too aggressively with these, and they seem to push up too far, and they always get explosive packs thrown on them, and they blow up. The 45mm 20K cannon, it's fine. But the BT-7 is going to be more mobile, and it has the same cannon, and it also has a machine gun. It is thinner skinned, though, so, you know, bear that in mind. If the T-50 is still available, then the T-50 is probably the best option for a lower BR tank. But because I have it, I can't see and tell you for sure that it's available. And I know that a lot of things that were available aren't and whatnot. The T-50 is also going to have the same gun as the other two, and it's also going to have a machine gun, but the fun thing here is that it gets two machine guns, and they're both in the coax, so you can turn your turret and shoot whatever. The benefit of the T-50 is that it's going to be very, very fast at 64 kilometers an hour, and it's got very, very good armor. Now, things can go through you, you're not invulnerable, but having the 45 mils of frontal hull armor that's angled back, you can deal very well with a lot of the enemies that can throw things at you. You also get access to it very early on in the tech tree. Like the T-50 that you research, it's right here. It's right at the beginning of BR-2. So, if I had to recommend just vehicles from all the nations, my number one plane would be the P-51 for America. My number one tank would probably be the Tiger 1 for Germany, but the IS-1 is probably tied with it. And I also want to give an honorable mention to the Panzer, or to the Panther G, and to the SU-85. I think those are both good options for higher tier vehicles. The G-14 is probably also a very strong plane at higher BR. For lower BR, the KV-1 hit the fascists, the aisle to the Grant for America. Those are all very good options. For the Germans, the Panzer IIIN. Now, if I had to crown one king between all of the BR-2s, it would be the Grant for America or the T-50 for Russia. I think they're about equal. With the Grant, you're going to be slower, but you have a ton of firepower and you're like a big immovable object. With the T-50, you can race around, do a ton of damage, and take a lot of punishment. Can't really tell you which one's better than the other. As for low-tier planes, I think the IL-2 is king, but I think the BF-110 is probably a close second. Hopefully this has helped you out. We should be getting new Gold Order vehicles soon in the not-so-far-off future, so stay on the lookout. I'll let you know when they come out. Let me know which Gold Order vehicles you guys have, which ones you're thinking about picking up from what's currently available. Let me know what your favorite Gold Order vehicle is that is no longer available. I think for me, it's probably the T-34 STZ or STE, whatever it was called, the black one. In part because being a black tank, it makes it harder to see on certain maps, especially depending on how the like sun position and the shadowing is on the map, but also because it's an up-armored T-34, and I think it performs very well because of that. As per usual, get out there, kick ass, take names, and win your games.